Amen. Ready? Amen. God bless you. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. It's good to be here on another Lord's Day. I'm going to say that every time the Lord allows me to come in the house of worship. It's good for us to be here. Amen. Amen. I want to thank God for another, as my grandmother used to say, day's journey that the Lord has kept us. Amen. With our life, health, and strength. Amen. I used to hear her say, I could have been dead and gone, but the Lord spared me one more time. We bring you greetings from the Correct Missionary Baptist Church here in the heart of Temple, Texas. Amen. In the heart of Temple, Texas, 321 South 10th Street, right here in Temple, Texas. You can join us every Sunday morning at this same time. Amen. 10 o'clock. Amen. On Virtual Church. Amen. We are happy just to be here. Want to share with you how some house cleaning we need to do. Want to share with you and just thank you. I received a letter from Sister Bonette Bostel, and I thought I would read it. Amen. Sister Bonette Bostel, who is our Women Day coordinator and chairman, that does a mighty good job. Amen. She wrote us a letter and said, Dear to Pastor Barnes and the Corinth family, I want to express my sincere gratitude to you and the Corinth family for your support and commitment to our 2020 Women's Day. Unfortunately, we had to cancel our program due to the coronavirus. However, with the Lord's blessings, we will return next year. Wear your mask, wash your hand, use your hand sanitizer, and stay in if you can. May God bless you all, and please be safe. Love you, Sister Bonette Bostel, Women Day Coordinator. I thought that was worth reading. Amen. She wanted to encourage the women of the Corinth Church. Amen. And her heart, amen, is the sisters of the church. Isn't that wonderful? Amen. What a marvelous spirit to have. Want to also share some more things. Funeral service for Lincoln District Association pastor that served in Lincoln District, president of the Evangelical Committee. Amen. And I just hate to see him, amen, go home to the Lord, but God knows best. Amen. Pastor Larry D. Johnson of Texas City, pastor of Mount Zion Baptist Church in Texas City, and to the Texas City church family, amen, we have you in our prayers. Amen. Funeral service will be Thursday at 10 o'clock, I believe 10 or 11 a.m. Amen, around that time. Then I want to also share, we have, amen, members that have lost family members here. Sister Mary Robinson and Sister Lanier Davis, amen, have lost their cousin here at the church. Brother Mitchell, amen, I believe his name, Brother Mitchell. Might be Henry Stevenson, I'm sorry, Brother Henry Stevenson. Lost him here in the church. Amen. He will be eulogized at Mount Zion Baptist Church for his pastor, Pastor Charles Mays. That's 10 o'clock. Amen. Monday morning. Amen. And then, Minister. Apostle Janelle Neely lost her uncle, amen, and his funeral service is next Friday, Brother Mitchell. Pray for that family And she's lost a brother last month and a brother this month and now an uncle. Amen. Amen. And all this has happened in the last month. Certainly, their family needs prayer. Amen. God bless you and God keep you. Again, as I pray, I want to shout out to all of you that are listening all over church land, Facebook, amen, YouTube. You can join us on YouTube, Corinth 321. Just type in on YouTube, Corinth 321, and we'll pop up. Say amen. Amen. And then Facebook will be showing also. Amen. Put us in there. Under Ulysses Barnes, amen, and we shall come forward. I want to thank all of you that are coming out on Sunday morning, amen, that are making your way to the house of prayer, to the Lord's house. Thank God for our sound man that's doing a marvelous job of keeping us on YouTube and putting us on Facebook every Sunday morning. He's here an hour and a half sometime ahead of time to make sure things are in line. You can't ask for nothing no more than that. I thought we would talk about, with all that's going on this morning, something caught my eye. I thought we would talk from Psalms 66. Psalms 66:18. Let me read that to you this morning. It says, Psalm 66:18, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. But verily, God have heard me, 19th verse. He have attended to the voice of my prayer. The 20th verse says, blessed be God, which have not turned away my prayers, nor his mercy from me. I thought, Lord, long and hard as I thought about that, and I praise the Lord, thought about that. And I thought long and hard, and I thought about a subject. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? I remember when cell phones first came out, and when they was coming out, and sometimes we would lose reception on the phone, and the other end of the party, you could half hear them, and sometimes you couldn't hear them at all. And we would say, can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? And they would say, well, get in a better place or get in a different area. And we would do that. And then we would ask the question, can you hear me now? Isn't that something? Isn't it amazing? There are times when we are listening for God to answer. And frustration seems to set in when we cry out to God and receive no clear answer. You want to ask the question, God, can you hear me now? Am I in the right position for you to hear me crying? The common we go through, common experience in prayer, and it often leads to our pain, confusion, and a sense of isolation. There have been times when I've called and prayed, and it seemed like to me, I don't know about you, but it seemed like to me I just didn't get an answer. Anybody out there ever prayed and looking for an answer and you didn't hear a word? You didn't feel nothing? You didn't. Nothing happened to you, and it leads to you. God, can you hear me now? Can you hear me praying now? I want to just encourage to let you know this morning. Although you can't hear nothing from the Lord, His presence is always with you and me. Whenever we call on the name of the Lord, regardless to whatever answer He has in store for us, He's always present when we pray. You don't have to ask Him if He can hear you now, because He hears and He knows all about you. It's a matter of a repentant heart. I thought about that when they would say, get in a better place, get in the right position so you can hear the reception. You got to get in the right position for God to answer your prayer. You have to have a repentant heart. You got to be sorry for all that is going on. And I'm here to tell you, when you pray with a sincere heart, when you take iniquity out of your heart, are you listening to me? When you remove malice from your heart, the writer says in the 18th verse, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. God will not respond when there is iniquity in your heart. A lot of times we don't get our questions answered. We don't get our prayers answered because of iniquity in our hearts. Yes, yes. If you cannot pretend to be what you are not, even if you declare, I don't hold no harbor in my heart against anybody, God knows your heart. The Lord will not support you, and the Lord will not be with you if you're carrying hatred in your heart. He will not hear you until you get in the right position. You got to get in the right position for God to hear your prayer. Listen what it says again. If I regard iniquity in my heart, if I got it there, the Lord will not hear me. David understood what he was writing. But then there is God's timing. You got to know when God is going to move. Are you praying? I used to hear my mother and father say, He may not come when you want Him, but it's right on time. Much frustration in prayer arises because we have false expectation. Are you listening? Our expectation are false. We harbor false expectation. In other words, we are living in an instant society. We want everything right now. We want everything instant. We want instant coffee. We want instant pancakes. We want instant aids. We want instant everything that we are involved in. We want it right now. We are living in a false expectation. The Bible says, in a false expectation. Whenever you realize that it's God's timing, not my timing, but God's timing. God moves when he decides to move. Yeah, therefore, we need to be careful about false expectation. We are living in a false surrounding. And the writer says here, Luke 1, 5 through 7. Let me read it to you. Luke 1, I will begin at the 6th verse. It says, and they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and the ordinance of the law, blameless. And they had no child, because that Elizabeth was barren, and they both were now well stricken in years. They had been trying and trying. Zacharias and Elizabeth had been trying and was righteous servants of the Lord. I want to stick a pin there, because you're living holy and because you're saved, sanctified, baptized, and filled with the Holy Spirit. It does not make God move any faster. Do you remember when Lazarus had died? Lazarus had died, and they sent for Jesus to come to the tomb. But Jesus took his time and didn't come on that time. But he came 3 days later. And their excuse was, our brother had been dead a long time. My sisters and brothers, God moves on his time. Zacharias and Elizabeth had been trying to have children. They was righteous before the Lord. The Bible says there were servants of God who haven't prayed for years. I'm not talking about day after day. I'm not talking about this morning prayer. I'm not talking about this evening prayer. I'm not talking about this yesterday prayer. But they prayed years and years and years, and yet had never conceived. Elizabeth was barren, was seen as a sign during that time that God was with a childless couple. In other words, you had done something to cause God not to bless you. Are you praying? It says here, but I got to also tell you, God's timing is not our timing. The 13th verse says in that same scripture, but the angel said unto him, fear not, Zacharias, for thy prayers is heard. It does not mean that God is not listening to your prayer. He heard you when you pray. Are you listening? God's timing is not our timing. We have to learn to trust in God if he will answer prayer. You ought to ask yourself this morning, am I trusting in the Lord? I heard David say, I will trust in the Lord until I die. Yeah, they used to sing a song, I will trust in the Lord. Oh, yes. You got to learn to trust in God until the Lord answers prayer. You got to learn how to encourage your own self. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said he may not come, but it ain't because he can't come. Can I get a witness here? Yes. I heard a writer in 2 Corinthians 12, 7 and 9, Paul said, identify the word thumb. Paul the apostle said, I got a thumb in my flesh. In other words, I got a stake in my flesh. I got something that's bothering me that I can't handle myself. I got trouble that I can't handle myself in the flesh, but I heard it cause him to be humiliated, but Paul kept right on believing in God. How many of us today, because we have a thorn in our flesh, want to give up on the Lord? I'm not worried this morning about a thorn in my flesh. I know trouble will come and trials will come, but we got to keep right on trusting in the Lord. I don't care nothing about coronavirus, because my faith is in the Lord. I heard my mother say, I will trust in the Lord. Can I get a witness here? But I heard the writer say that it increased not only Paul's humiliation, but sometimes God will leave your problem in your problem. He'll leave the thorn in your flesh so you can pray a little bit longer. He'll leave the thorn in your flesh so you will learn how to say thank you, Jesus. He'll leave your problem so you won't get too high. He'll leave your problem on the inside. I don't know nobody that don't have some trials and tribulations, but we ought to learn to thank God for our trials and tribulation. When trouble comes, we need to go to our secret closet and say, Lord, I thank you for one more day. Are you praying with me? So Paul had prayed not one time. Paul had prayed not two times. Paul prayed three times for the Lord to remove the stone, remove the thorn in his side. And God never did move. Can I get a witness here? But I heard the writer said, my grace is sufficient. And I get a witness here, no matter whatever you're going through, for sometimes Christ's power perfects our weakness. When you're weak, you're strong. And when you're strong, you may be weak. But I heard God's power will transform our weakness into a victory. Can I get a witness here? Yeah. I may be going through a storm, but my storm will transfer into my victory. Can I get a witness here? When I got storms in my life, I don't mind going to my secret closet, getting down on my knees, saying, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. When I got storms in my life, when trials come, I know how to turn my plate over and fast and pray. For I heard a Bible say, these times come out by fasting and pray. If you want victory, all you gotta do is go to your secret closet. Give God your heart this morning. He'll transform your weakness into a victory. Somebody ought to say victory is in Jesus. Can I get a witness here? Victory is in the Lord. I come back to also let you know, because he does not answer when you think he ought to answer, it does not mean that he will not bring dependence or presence of victory to you. Yes, he's not coming when you think he ought to come, but whenever he shows up, he'll show out. Can I get a witness? He'll lift your burdens. He'll pick you up, turn you around. Oh, yeah. One more thing I want to close with. You got to know that he's a believing God. Anybody here know God will? Anybody here know God is able? Anybody here know God can? Yes, God promised. He promised to give us wisdom to believe, to endure our trials and tribulation. Don't throw up your hand. Go down on your knees in trials and tribulation. Go down on your knees. Have confidence in prayer. Have confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ. When crisis comes, have confidence in God. When the glass seems half full, when the glass seems half empty, have confidence in God. When there ain't no jobs around, have confidence in God. When sickness is all around, have confidence in God. He will supply your need. He will make a way out of no way. Can I get a witness here? Pray with a sincere heart. When you go down to pray, you gotta be real. Somebody used to sing a song, he's real in my soul. And I come to ask you this morning, is the Lord real in your soul? Is it real in your heart this morning? Is it real? Says he's real. You gotta pray with a sincere heart this morning. You gotta take iniquity out of your heart. You gotta take hate out of your heart. You gotta take malice out of your heart. You gotta take weakness out of your heart and say, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. Say yeah. Say yeah. God is able. Do you know he's able? God is able, and not only able, but God is willing to hold you up this morning. He's willing if you put your trust in the Lord. He's willing if you have confidence in the Lord. He's willing. He will answer prayer. Is there anybody here that know God will answer prayer? Is there anybody out there that know God answer prayer? Have the Lord been good to you? Have God made a way for you? Have God opened doors for you? Why don't you say yes? Yes. He's able. He's able. I know prayer will change things. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me? Now is the message of the day. God, can you hear me? I'm just calling on you because you are my God. You've been good to me. You've been better to me than I've been to my own self. Wake me up this morning. Clothe me in my right mind. Put food on my table. Clothes on my back. And I'm here to say I'm running for my life. Are you running for your life this morning? Run on while the blood is running warm in your vein. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. And every now and then, just ask the Lord, can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? I'm calling on you, Master. Can you hear me now? What a way. What a way. What a way. One wish. One wish. Hallelujah. One wish all you fathers. A happy Father's Day. Let me say this. 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 There are those that may not have no children, but you've been a father. Right there for those that don't have father figures. You've been right there. Want to wish you a happy Father's Day. God is love. God is peace. God is forever. Whatever you desire Him to be. He's right there for you. If you are in your home, if you are on your job, wherever you are, close your eyes and say, Lord, can you hear me now? You don't have to say a word, because He knows what you're saying already. Bow your head. Say, Master, can you hear me now? You can join us every Sunday morning at 321 South 10th Street here in the heart of Temple, Texas. This is the Corinth Missionary Baptist Church where we celebrate the goodness of the Lord. Every Sunday morning, we are lifting up His name because we have power in the name of Jesus. How many know He's here? Look at somebody and say, He's able. He's able. Do you know He's able this morning? Won't He do it? Won't He do it? Won't He do it? I feel pretty good. Won't He do it? He'll do it right now. Give Him you, and He'll give you Him. Just like that. God bless you, and God keep you, is our prayer.